Hello, today I will show you Castelfranco radicchio. I noticed that in my vegetable garden there were some plants that were rotting because it rained for 2 weeks and this didn't do too good to the radicchios. I just cut some plants that were not in great health, but this is the Castelfranco radicchio. As you can see, it looks like a flower, very white, with red spots everywhere. It's beautiful. I really love Castelfranco radicchio. This is one special cultivar from Castelfranco, which is a city near Venice in the Veneto region. These are all radicchio from Castelfranco, but since the rain ruined them, not all of them were ready. This one was ready with the good coloration. This is not as ready because it's still closed. This is closed too, but at least it has the colors. This don't have the color. It was too early, but since the leaves were rotting, see, I needed to take it out. And this is not ready at all. As you can see, it's still green, but it was really rotting. I just cleaned all the rotting leaves, and now I will just cook it and eat it anyway. So that's it. Now I will need to take all the leaves out of the plants, cut with the scissors, cut the rotten part of the leaves. See, I have to cut all the rotten part of the leaves. And then I will cook them and I will show you how I do this. I just cleaned all the radicchio from Castelfranco, as you can see, all the leaves are cleaned, and now I show you how to cook it. So you need some garlic and onion. I used 3 onions for this amount, but you can do as you please. There is no set rule for this preparation. So we need to cut the onion. For this preparation, I'm using the purple onion, but you can use any onion, really. You can use the white onion or the orange onion, whatever onion you have. Oh my god, this onion is killing me. Oh my god. And as for the sicory, I'm using the Castelfranco radicchio, but you can use any other kind of sicory because I don't think you will find Castelfranco radicchio outside of Veneto. So the onion is cooked, so now we can put some oil in a pan. Oh my god. Some olive extra virgin olive oil. You can put quite a good amount. Oh my god, the onions are killing me. And we need to start the fire. And once the oil is frying, I will put the onion inside. Now I need to get away from these onions because I'm dying. My camera just trolled me, so I couldn't film, but when the oil is boiling, you just put the onion and you will cook the onion until they become soft. Now that the onion is cooked, we can put some pepper. Some salt. And more pepper, because I like pepper. This pepper grinder is broken sometimes, the lid just comes off. Now we wait a couple of more minutes until the onion releases the taste. And in the meantime, we put the radicchio. Once all the radicchio is cooked, you let it cook for 1 hour, maybe even more. It has to become very soft, like a cream. So I will show you the final result when it will be completely cooked. And remember to put the lid on to keep the moisture inside. And this is how the Castelfranco radicchio looks when it's cooked. As you can see, it's almost a soft cream, very soft cream. And you can use this as a base for pasta, for rice, risotto, or for a pie, for a you know, the radicchio pie. You can use this in place of spinach, and so this is a base for other preparation, but you can also eat like this because it tastes really, really good. I will eventually show you how I make risotto with radicchio and pumpkin. Thank you for watching, and catch you on my next recipe.